This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to do a couple of basic examples of calculating drug dosages. So here's the first problem. The order reads 600 milligrams. The tablets contain 200 milligrams. How many tablets should be given? Okay, so we're going to start out with the order. That's 600 milligrams. That's going to be the beginning of the left side of an equation. The right side of the equation is going to tell me how many tablets should be given. So I'm going to leave a space for the number of tablets, and I'll just write the unit, which is tablets. I know that each tablet contains 200 milligrams. I'm going to take that information and make a fraction. The fraction is going to be one tablet. That's the numerator, over how much each tablet contains, 200 milligrams. And since I'm dealing with fractions, I might want to take the 600 milligrams and make that into a fraction. I'll just put it over 1. You don't have to do that, but if it makes it easier for you, you can. When I'm dealing with fractions, I want to multiply all of the numerators, multiply across, and then multiply all of the denominators. But before that, I want to see if I can simplify what I've got. Well, I've got milligrams in both the numerators and the denominators. So I'm going to cancel out the milligrams. I've got 600 and 200, so I know I could divide both of these numbers by 100. So let's turn that 600 into a 6 by crossing out the two zeros. Turn the 200 into a 2 by crossing out the two zeros. I've got a 6 and I've got a 2. I could simplify that. I could divide both of those numbers by 2. So let's divide the 6 by 2 and I'll get 3. I'll divide the 2 by 2 and I get 1. And now my denominator has just a 1 and a 1 in it, so I'm not even going to have to worry about the denominator. If I multiply the numerators across, I get 3 times 1 tablet, and that's going to mean I've got 3 tablets. Okay? So basically what I did when I set this up was write on the right side, on the left side, the amount that was ordered. That was the 600 milligrams. On the left side of the equation, I wrote the units that I was going to be dealing with, tablets. I took the remaining information, the one tablet contains 200 milligrams, made a fraction, and then before multiplying, I canceled out whatever I could. Then I multiplied across, ended up with my answer. Here's another one. The order is for 150 milligrams. Scored tablets on hand contain 80 milligrams. Remember, if it's a scored tablet, it means if you need to, you can cut it in half. How many tablets should be given? Okay, so the order was for 150 milligrams. So I'll write 150 milligrams. I'll put that over 1, since I'll be dealing with fractions. On the right side of my equation, I'll leave a space for the answer, and the unit is going to be tablets, so it'll be some number of tablets. And then my last bit of information is that one tablet, or each tablet, contains 80 milligrams. So I'll make a fraction, one tablet, over 80 milligrams. And now before multiplying, I'll see what I can simplify. I can simplify the units. I'll cross out the milligrams in this numerator and this denominator. I've got 150 as a numerator and 80 as a denominator. So I could divide both of those by 10. That would leave me with 15 and 8. I can't simplify this anymore. So multiplying across, I'm going to get 15 tablets, which I've already got the tablets written. And that's going to be over what I get when I multiply the denominators, which is just 8. So we've got 15 over 8 tablets. Let's take that fraction. We could put it into a calculator, and that would tell us that that was equal to 1.875 tablets. Now at this point, we have to think about whether we want to round this up or down, or whether we have to cut the tablets in half. So let's remember the rules for rounding when we're dealing with tablets that we can cut in half. scored tablets. So if the decimal part of our answer is between 0 and 0.24, then we just round down. If the decimal part of the answer is between 0.25 and 0.74, then we would give a half a tablet. We would have, in other words, 1.5 tablets. If the decimal part is between 0.75 and 0.99, then we would round up. Well, the decimal part was 0.875, so that would mean that we round this answer up, and we're going to end up with 2 tablets. Okay, so once again, the basic approach was I write down the amount ordered that starts at, that's on the left side of the equation. The right side is the units that I'm dealing with. And then I take the number of milligrams there are in a tablet and I make a fraction, cancel out whatever I can, multiply across, turn the answer into a decimal if it's not a simple answer, and then decide what kind of rounding I have to do. Okay, so that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.